before we go on the land and find some treasure, we're going to have to find out how it works. So we're going to try to go through the settings. But firstly, I'm just explaining what you get with it. It's the 11 by 9 search head, which with cover, bolts that fasten it through, which are straightforward. But these square tubing stems, which are brilliantly solid. We've got one, which adjusts with a clip, perfect. And then the other one, solid machine. Then you've got the display and the connections. Also, this works with wireless headphones and or a direct headphones. Well, here we are with the wireless headphones. Simple, switch on the machine and it will automatically connect. They're well sturdy and good quality headphones. Like them, great. So we just press the side button on the right hand side top one here and it will link up the headphones, unlinked up, and as you can see there's a little light there, or a little wavy lines there to say that it's linked up with your wireless headphones. Perfect, great. So let's go continue with the settings. To simply adjust the display and handle, gripping handle, which is brilliant, it's three screws here, positive screws to adjust, and you can adjust this armrest according to your arm length. Important that for when you're swinging a metal detector around. Aha, this is how you condense the machine. Simply pull the levers here, condense, clip back, and open that one, and look at that. Packed away, simple and small, without any space taken up. What helps a great deal in metal detecting is having an arm strap. Once you've got your arm strap fixed, you can go for ages on a field detecting. Perfect. In harmony with a detector. Great. This is how you turn the Quest Pro on. You just press the M button and the power goes on. It's quite easy to pinpoint. All we do is press the target button. And that's all it is! Aha! And there's your target. To adjust the sensitivity is just a matter of these two buttons here, which actually sorts out quite a lot of your modes as well. So let's just go up and down. As you can see, increasing. If I increase it to 83, I think it goes up to 99 sensitivity. We'll go down, up and down, so that's quite easy and straightforward. The depth meter here, battery life there, and volume there, which is altered by two side buttons here are volume. Up, down. We have an interesting feature at the back here, a little light at the back which you can shine like a little torch, and all you do is to turn it on is to second button down and then it's lit, and that just shines down onto the search head or the area that you're detecting, which illuminates it. It saves you having a head torch. Brilliant feature. To move from different programs, you just press the metal detecting symbol with the little arrow press and it moves into seven different modes. Coins, beach, coin field, catch, custom one, custom two. I'm going to put it in jewellery for the moment. Ground balance is to pump the coil. Until more or less it's gone away. And there you go, it's ground balanced. Simple as that. I'm going to put it back into... back into jewellery. We'll try in jewellery to begin with and see how it goes. Disc 1. These disc 1, disc 2 are for the custom settings. If you want to customise the detector to your requirements, fine tune, you use disc 1 or disc 2. The other modes are just preset modes for the machine, which automatically have a discrimination level to different targets and different metals. Here we are with different targets to see what kind of ID numbers come out, because right in the middle you've got an ID number. Here we go. ID number 50 on a hammered coin, 56. And gives you the depth reading on the right hand side. Look. Just there. Hammered. Target ID. And then we've got a big piece of brass, which gives a high reading. 8480. You dig that. Tin. That's a small bit of tin, but they go larger than that. So 50 plus. Under. And we've got a button. 67. Copper button. Now we've got Georgia third half penny. 86. Copper brass brooch. It's low figures. Or mid tone, if you like. '56. Then kind of gold wedding band. And this is a rusty nail. Even a crackle there, look. Rusty nail. Not even a noise. You can download an app which is Google Maps, where you can mark each finding an area to analyze for a later reference.